In this next page, we're going to talk about the nucleophilic addition of neutral amines to carbonyls. And this is going to yield imines and enamines. All right, guys, so the difference between an imine and an enamine is simply going to be the type of amine that the carbonyl is reacting with, okay? As you guys can see, when you react a carbonyl with primary amine, okay, you're going to get an imine. An imine has a functional group of basically a nitrogen with a double bond on it and possibly an R group on the top. Okay? So think about an imine is kind of like a carbonyl. Oh, wow, carbonyl. Carbonyl, but with a nitrogen. Okay? So if you can think about, if it would have been a carbonyl with an oxygen, that's an imine with a nitrogen on it. Now notice that when I react a secondary amine, I get a different looking compound. Now this amine has two R groups, and instead of getting the double bond directly on the N, I actually get it down towards one of the R groups. Now we're going to go through both of these mechanisms completely, but I just want to ask you guys, why do you think that double bond might move? Why do you think it might be towards the bottom? Guys, because if you have two R groups on your N, that means that if I were to put the double bond on the N, I would get a formal charge, right? So to eliminate the formal charge, I'm going to have to move the double bond down to one of the R groups, okay? And that's the biggest difference between an imine and an enamine. In fact, they're pretty much the same exact reaction except for the final step, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to go through both of these mechanisms. And I do want to say one thing really quick, that both of these mechanisms are going to pass through a very important intermediate. And that intermediate is called the iminium cation. The iminium cation looks like this. It's your nitrogen with a double bond and with two things on it, so either H's or R's, and a plus charge. So two of these and a plus charge, okay? So we're always going to pass through the iminium cation, and then how we resolve that cation is what determines whether it's going to be an imine or an enamine, okay? So let's go ahead and look into the mechanism of an imine.